The south of France, playground of the rich and famous, and home to Les Roches Blanches, an exclusive five-star hotel providing high-end service for over 100 years. And where Fred Siriex, who has run some of the world's most prestigious hotels and restaurants, is giving back to the industry that made him.
I've spent my whole career running places like this. Now it's time to pass on my knowledge and expertise.
Ça va? Tu vas bien?
Salut.
A career in hospitality is just so glamorous. You can travel the world, you know, meeting people you would never, ever meet. Royalty, film stars, millionaires.
With hospitality facing the biggest crisis in recruitment for a generation, Fred is giving 12 eager young Brits...
I'm fed up of working in the supermarket, scanning an asparagus tips.
..the chance to change their lives forever.
I'm a farmer, drive tractors and look after cows.
..by learning five-star service.
Thank you for calling Les Roches Blanches.
Take me to my room.
..from the best of the best.
You are in the Church of Service. And I'm the high priest.
If Fred actually thought that I could have a future in hospitality here, I'd actually probably start crying, I'm not gonna lie.
Over 4 weeks, these 12 hopefuls will compete to win a job in high-end hospitality.
Yeah, we can arrange a chocolate massage. What kind of chocolate would you like?
And a cash prize.
It's confusing, bruv.
Okay, listen, don't call me bruv.
But it won't be easy.
Oh, my God!
I guarantee you, I'm more intelligent than you and you.
In a world where guest satisfaction rules...
I like sex on the beach.
This is fresh, straight from the French Riviera.
..and everything must run seamlessly...
S'il te plaît, petit Jésus, s'il te plaît.
..will any one of them have what it takes?
I don't think the world of five-star luxury is ready for someone like me.
..to become...
I'm just finding it really hard.
..Fred's winning recruit.
What have I done to myself?
Who has been to South of France before? Anyone?
No.
Fred's new recruits are en route to one of the most exclusive resorts in the world.
Has anyone actually ever been to a five-star luxury hotel?
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Have you? Oh, we got a bougie one. Serving pizza is not luxury. I don't deserve this life. I deserve way more than this. Eating caviar. I don't even like caviar, but I want to be, you know, trying it. Champagne on tap. There is 12 of us. And only one winner.
With a year's job on offer...
Where's the competition? Where is it?
..they'll be competing to master the world of five-star hospitality.
What jobs do you guys not want to do?
I'm not cleaning.
I know the value of hard work. If I can cycle up these massive Brighton hills and deal with the massive gusts of wind coming in from the seafront, I can do anything.
Sous le ciel de Paris s'envole une chanson.
Les Roches Blanches Hotel is known as paradise on the rocks. Winston Churchill was once a regular here, and now guests pay up to £10,000 a night for a luxury stay. And it's here where our 12 hospitality hopefuls will be trained up by the industry's finest, Fred Siriex.
The recruits are very lucky. They're gonna get to learn from the best how to be the best. I am a little bit nervous, but I've always said I can work with anyone and still deliver the best guest experience, so I guess the proof's in the pudding.
Are you ready for it, guys?
So, can the recruits make a good first impression on Fred and the hotel staff?
Good morning, bonjour, bienvenue. How are you?
Very good.
Good. Welcome to Les Roches Blanches Hotel. This is one of the most exclusive hotels in the world. This is what you call a five-star luxury boutique hotel. Now, over the next few weeks, you will help to run this hotel. And each and every one of you will be personally responsible for maintaining and exceeding the guest expectations. So you've got your work cut out here. You all said you wanted to change your lives and your careers. I'm giving you this opportunity.
Time to be professional. It's time to grow up. I could be the Polish version of Fred.
This is real. If if you are not good enough, you're going home. At the end of the season, there can only be one winner.
Boxing does have an expiry date, and obviously I'm 27, so I've still got a good few years left, but it's not forever. So this is the biggest opportunity I'll get.
The recruit who impresses me the most will get a world-class placement in hospitality and £10,000 to help you kickstart your new career.
I'm very competitive. If I lose, I'll say someone else cheated. Because I really don't like to lose.
This experience is going to change your life.
Yeah!
I think you get the gist, but there's one thing that we're going to have to sort out is all this screaming. You've got to be professional here. Otherwise, you won't make it to the end. All right? Would you like to follow me, please?
Successful resort staff need excellent organizational, communication and problem-solving skills. The very best can earn six-figure salaries.
This way, please.
And for Fred's recruits to reach these heights, they'll need to master every job from reception to pool service, housekeeping to valet, and take charge of prestigious VIP events.
This is a world that they've never experienced, and they're about to have a taste of it now.
Oh my God! Now I feel like I've seen heaven. Luxury vibes.
Beautiful, man. Never ever been anywhere like this in my whole life, you know what I'm saying? So it's such a surreal experience, you know what I mean?
Who's the biggest celeb you've had?
Winston Churchill.
And he did.
Have you ever had any Kardashians?
No.
No. Well, I'm the first. I am a five-star bitch trapped in a two-star area. Rotherham is just not glamorous. I definitely don't fit in. I mean, I'm way too pretty. I'm here because I want to change my life.
Hey, you all right? You're beautiful.
I think the staff are probably feeling a little bit concerned.
Take you out, innit? Buy you some champagne and that.
No.
Before, I didn't want to work hard at all, innit? I wasn't taking life seriously, but now, every time I look at my daughter, that's when I start taking things serious, you know what I mean?
Oh, my God!
Ah. You?
Oh my God! How much does it cost to stay here?
£2,500.
£2,000. That's insane. Like, it's a cost of living crisis.
Housekeeping departments are spending a lot of hours doing the rooms and especially the bed. So this is what you cannot do.
Yeah, they start to annoy me a little bit. Yeah, I mean it's okay now. We just started, but soon they need to understand how things work here.
This is about a 200 bottle of champagne.
200 quid for champagne? The fuck? Even if I was earning that much money and being rich, I'm not paying 200 quid. I'll give it back, get a refund. But I'm gonna keep it inside, gotta deliver.
Wow, look at this, guys.
Jeez. VIP settings.
Wow, that is amazing.
What if you fall off the edge? Is it like a net or something? I think I'll wrap my head around it soon. It's just how the other half live.
So tell me, how was your tour?
Beautiful. Unbelievable. Amazing.
Very pretty.
It's great. Loved it.
Really? What did you like about it?
The views.
Okay.
The inside. Yeah. Everything. There's not one thing I didn't like.
What about you? What did you think?
It feels like I'm dreaming, bruv. It feels so surreal. I can't lie. I still don't believe that I'm here, bruv. I think I'm real. I can't lie.
I'm not your bruv. Okay? My name is Fred or Mr. Serie X. Very happy for you to call me Fred, but don't call me bruv.
All right, cool.
All right? Right. There's only one way for me to find out what you're made of and what you're capable of. It's for you to run lunch today.
Yay.
Wow.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Start thinking about what you're about to do. How would you serve lunch here in a five-star luxury hotel? I can't wait to see what you're capable of doing. Okay, we've got no time to lose, guys. Go and get in your uniform. They are inside. See you in a bit.
Thank you.
Woo! Oh, shut up.
I can't believe what I have just done. I have just asked 12 new recruits with no training to look after lunch for 36 VIP guests. And I'm asking them to do it from the moment they arrive. You know, it's a chance for me to see how adaptable they are, how resourceful they are. Can they put it off? We'll find out.
The recruits' first shift is in the hotel's fine dining restaurant, Les Belles Canailles, where lunch can cost hundreds of pounds a head.
Oh, you're looking good, guys. OK?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. Thanks. Let's get started.
They'll be working in pairs to serve each table.
I have given them zero information. Even though they have no experience, no training, I want to know whether they can put it off.
Remember the three things you need to think about. Setting up your table, making sure you know how the service will run, and learning the menu.
Fred's recruits have just 30 minutes to prepare the restaurant before the VIP guests arrive.
They're all different sizes. So we just get everyone of each size. My first ever service in a five-star hotel. We've had like 2 seconds to get changed. We're gonna get thrown in the deep end, so I'm shitting it.
They'll need to deliver service with a smile and show an understanding of basic hygiene.
What is this napkin here?
Oh, I was just wiping there.
Ah, okay.
Some of this air.
But the thing is, you're putting it under your armpit and then you are wiping the plate and then somebody's gonna eat out of this plate.
Yeah, no, I understand.
That's just not folded right. It's annoying me. I take everything so serious, sometimes a bit too serious, and set it out like that.
So not on the napkin?
No. Did I say the napkin? Fred told me from the minute you step foot in that door, the clock's going. I am 100% in it to win it.
You need to be clear. What's your job? What's your job? Do you know your menu? Get on it.
Learning the menu of 9 gourmet dishes before their guests arrive...
What is this? How do I say that?
..will be key to a successful service.
It's not a translated version.
I've never been so stressed in my entire life. I thought, you know what, fuck this. I don't know how I'm going to cope.
You'll be better at reading that, because I'm dyslexic.
So am I. I've been doing hospitality for about 8 years now. I want to grow up a bit. I just feel like I want to get out of my comfort zone. I got this.
Honestly, I physically cannot read that.
I'm going to make a tea of myself if I read this.
Guys, you've got less than 5 minutes before service starts.
I'm stressing out.
No, don't get upset. Doesn't matter, because this is the first time anybody's done it.
Yeah, I know.
I'll read it out. Do you want to take orders? How well can you read your own writing?
Yeah, I can read my writing.
Right, that's fine. You can do that, because I can't write.
I can.
I don't speak French. The menu's in French. I'll read it out as best I can, which is probably very poorly.
But anything you're unsure of, I'll try help you.
Right. Might as well be in Arabic, to be honest. Do we have to read it in French?
Well, it's only in French.
I didn't know she was dyslexic as well, so anybody that's taking orders is gonna be rubbish.
Just relax, breathe.
The lunch service is now 10 minutes behind schedule.
Bonjour, enchanté. Désolé pour l'attente, désolé. Ladies, how are you?
So the recruits will have to work even harder to impress their guests.
Exactement, comme ça, tout le monde apprend quelque chose. Please, take a seat.
Hello. My name's Lacey. This is my colleague, Tom.
Hiya, nice to meet you.
Yeah, we'll be looking after you today.
Bonjour. Comment tu t'appelles?
Can I start you off with any still or sparkling water?
Jackson. The smile is part of the uniform.
Okay.
And a smile is not a smile if I can't see your teeth.
Okay.
All right,
okay,
mate?
Yeah. The start, I was nervous and, like, a bit shook, because you were like a bunch of good-looking girls, well.
Today's wine list features 3 award-winning local wines.
1 red, 2 rosé, 1 white and 2 sparkling waters.
But under pressure, even the simplest tasks are proving difficult.
What would you like?
What do you have?
I ain't got a clue, love, to be honest, but I can have a look for you and then get the menu of the drink. It's 5-star. You know what I mean? I worked in a cafe, but that's not a 5-star hotel with these rich-ass people.
We have white wine, red wine, and we have rosé. What would you like?
I like Sex on the Beach.
15 minutes in, the recruits haven't served a single drink.
So you're looking to order your food yet, or would you rather wait for the food to come? For the drinks to come.
And the stress of face-to-face service is proving too much for Levi.
It's just way out of my comfort zone. You've got customers who've got money. They're just looking at you funny.
Levi, a real smile. A smile like when you're happy.
I know.
If you're happy,
are
you smile? Come on!
Because I feel like everyone's looking.
We're here to do a job, deliver the service. The thing is with Levi is that he's very self-conscious and he's very worried that people are looking at him and judging him. He thinks the guests here are better than him because they've got money.
Levi, you're meant to put that in the ice bucket and...
Yeah, you're coming to do some else.
What the fun?
In front of the guests.
Do we have to do it in front of... Oh, my God, literally, I'm telling you, I'm actually, like, walking out after I've done this with Heather. Oh, this is fucking awful. Heather, I'm literally going to have an anxiety attack. I need 5 minutes. Can you just follow me to this table? I'm literally stressed. I feel trapped. I feel nervous, anxious.
I need 5 minutes, unless I'm going to go mad.
OK, so
I'm
gonna go, have 5 minutes. Go just for it. Sounds
do,
good to
do,
me.
Do the wine, yeah?
Of course.
Thank you. Never put myself in a situation like this. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Fucking absolute bullshit.
Can I get you any water?
This is stress. It's hot.
It's chaos. I'm sweating. I really don't know what's going to happen. Yeah, it's not very good.
I actually don't even know if I'll be able to walk back in there now.
Wait!
Luxury resort on the French Riviera, 12 young Brits are competing to win the job of a lifetime in the rarefied world of five-star hospitality.
Mithil.
For their first taste of high-end service, Fred Cyriex has set them a high-pressure challenge, serving a gourmet lunch to VIP guests.
Yes, sir. Thank you. That's good. The recruits are out of their depth, but I had to do it. I had to see what they were capable of.
I'm so sorry. Honestly, I'm so sorry.
After an embarrassing water spillage, Lacey is trying to win back the trust of her guest.
I'm at a tap. I can't stop. I'm just stressed out. It's overwhelming.
Don't cry. Be sure about yourself.
Yeah.
You go.
Yeah.
You show.
Yeah.
Right now.
Right, I'm so sorry about that. Can I just give you another one?
We've already had tears. But, you know, these tears come from a good place because she cares, she wants to do well. And I like that. I love people who care.
Right, let's start that again, shall we? Right?
Mademoiselle, what would you like for your starter?
Takeaway delivery courier Heather is flying solo on her service. Her partner Levi is missing in action after a crisis of confidence.
Oh, does it feel that Levi is not here?
You just got to do what you got to do. So I'm just getting on with it.
Well done, well done. Well, don't let me keep you.
Of course. Keep
on it. Well done.
I really want to win this. And if anything, Levi not being here means I can shine a little bit. I'll be noticed a little bit more. All the steaks are cooked medium, desserts on the back. Thank you very much.
Levi, how are you doing?
I just want to explode when I can't do something and everyone's looking at me and I'm expected to do something.
I can see it's hard for you and I can see your stress. But remember, everybody's in the same boat.
Everyone just passed, everyone's just got money.
No, they're not. The people up there, the guests, they are human beings. They are people with a heart, with families, with children, with the same problems that you have.
Not like me, because I've got money. They're completely different people.
No, they are the same. You're here because you want to change your life, you want to change your career. And this is the first test. And the only way to get over it is to take it upon yourself, get up and go and do it. But when you walk up these stairs, you've got to go and start smiling. Come with me. There's already drama. But you know, it's just fear. And you've got to be able to fight the fears inside yourself. And the only way to confront your fear is for Levi to go and face it head on. And that's what he's done. I hope he's going to be successful. Let's see.
Hello, does anyone need any more water?
In Fred's world, attention to detail is everything.
You have to twist the thing, not twist the bottle.
I think our main struggle is opening the wine. And then Dippy's pouring fat glasses of rosé. But you know what? If we get them drunk, they won't know what's going on. Just keep feeding them.
You do.
After the medal. Okay, thank you very much.
I just had some very good comments about Dippy, and they were praising him. He's got a beautiful smile, and he wants to do well. You can tell he cares.
And while some recruits are starting to shine...
I'm trying to make the order. They're telling me I need 6 starters.
Yes.
Others are struggling with the basics.
The dishes haven't been written correctly. The chef cannot read the tickets.
So I need to know, Lance, how many...
Everyone just keeps talking to me at the same time. It's confusing, bro.
Okay, listen, don't call me bro. How many of these do you want? Tell him. They may have to go back and take their order twice, maybe 3 times, to get it right. But the chef doesn't know what he's got to cook. I mean...
Champagne?
Yes, please, for me.
Would you like to take it, or should I...
No, I'm certainly not taking it, as I'm a paying guest.
Okay. Oh, my God. Oh, I'm so sorry. I will get you one. So sorry. I will get you another one.
Are you okay, madame? We don't have any champagne on you.
No, I'm just stressing out. Serving the guests and champagne after wine after champagne. I want one. I need a fat beer and a gin or something.
Désolé.
I just want to cry.
Professional boxer Jackson is trying to flirt his way through the service.
When we go on a night out, party, you have to come.
Yeah.
You have to come. Oh, go. I won't be serving you, though.
Little Jackson, bless his soul. It's a bit too much.
She's dead fit, but she's dead tall. One on there.
I get he wants to flirt. I get he wants to, you know, maybe to find a little French girl or whatever, but we're here to work.
Don't matter how tall you are when your legs are behind your head. Hey! You're not with me on that one.
I'm really not, babe.
With the lunch service coming to an end, have Fred's new recruits shown any promise?
St. Pierre fish again? Yes. Here you go, madame. Enjoy.
The service was difficult, but it was to be predicted. They had no training. The thing is, though, they impressed me because they cared. They wanted to do well. They wanted to do their best. And the guests felt it.
I'm so proud of you.
Allez, salut. Au revoir. Merci beaucoup.
Right now, I feel relieved it's over. Proud of myself. It was either sink or swim, and I got back up and started swimming again.
So if you were going to give them a score out of 5, what would you give them?
5.
5 out of 5?
We smashed it.
Smashed it.
15 minimum, first day. Did you guys enjoy your meals?
Yes.
I tested my patience, I'm not gonna lie, bruv. So close to cracking and just being so rude.
Right now, I'm feeling like the winner, but I probably won't be feeling that in 2 or 3 days when it'll be me crying instead of one of the other people.
That was your first ever 5-star service. So how do you feel you did?
Awful.
Did you? Why do you say that?
Lack of experience.
Totally.
Yeah.
That was a tough ask. I always knew that.
I knew it was going to be hard, but this was harder than I thought.
What about you? What do you think, Molly?
It went awful, like Tom said.
They were very difficult guests, the guests that you had. I think some of you are having certain issues within yourselves. And these fears, maybe they are holding you back. I'm here to help you, right? But you have to help yourselves. All of you, you need to think about your demeanor. The smiles, because that's what hospitality is about. It's about the connections and the bonds that you create and share with people. And that's your job. Right, it's been a long day. Now it's time for you to go and relax, and I'll see you tomorrow bright and early, okay? Yay. All right, good night, guys.
Bye. Bye. Thank you.
Well done.
What a day.
Guys, we can actually go wild because there's no 5-star luxury people around.
I've just sent the recruits to their staff accommodation. I think they're gonna have a bit of a shock. Some of them actually thought they were staying here. Not quite the same standard.
Oh my God, it's a fucking camping.
No!
While training with Fred, the recruits will stay at a local caravan park.
If that camp's rocking, don't come knocking.
Can I just check my contract? Because I didn't remember seeing mobile home. Oh. It's giving
skeggy. It's a
wave, it's a wave. Okay, this is our cabin.
This room is so shit.
I'm extremely disappointed, innit? I thought I was going to be staying in a 5-star hotel, bruv. And now we're here, and it's shit.
Welcome home, my honey.
Welcome
home.
I don't know if I made the right decision going with you, though, but we move.
Listen, you're going to have the best time. Oh, it's going to be boring, fuckers.
Right.
I would have shared with Lacey, Orla,
no,
Francesca.
I couldn't share with a girl.
Oh, my God, this alcohol.
To help them settle in, Fred supplied luxury hampers, showcasing the finest French cuisine.
Oh, my God, there's a fucking snail.
We're in! We did it!
Get alcohol in it, though.
Yeah, mate.
What's the percent?
12.5. We're going to be fucked. We're going to be shot.
You're sharing it, because I feel like you're a bit stingy. You're going to be taking it all.
I dare you to let whoever you think the fittest boy is suck your finger.
Oh! I'll deliver it.
No, you're out. Wait, right, let me decide. Choose. I need you to decide.
Jackson!
Oh! 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 Oh!
It's been a long day for the recruits, and Jackson and Lacey seem keen to hit the sack. They'll all need plenty of rest if they're going to impress Fred and be back on shift early tomorrow morning. It's a new day on the French Riviera, where Fred Siriez is offering a life-changing job opportunity to one of 12 young Brits who impresses him the most. As they battle it out in the glamorous world of luxury hospitality.
What the fuck happened last night?
It's 7 a.m. and a slow start for the recruits after a late night of drinking games.
We used to go to bed together. Oh, where are you?
We've just witnessed it! Jackson is in Lacey's cabin! Where have you been?
Where have you been, bitch?
Do you think anything happened then?
God knows what they've been up to in that caravan.
Last night was very, very rowdy. Everybody went to bed very late. I said goodnight to Jackson, he wasn't in his bed.
Did you actually stay in here last night?
Fell asleep once when I was in bed by accident.
Don't know where he slept. I can have a very good guess of where he slept.
I wouldn't have done that. They each their own.
How do you work that?
You plug it in and you push it around the shirt.
I don't even know if I've slept. I'm so tired. Me and Jackson had a cuddle. That was it. Yeah. Keeping it classy.
My head is literally banging, it's spinning. Being 100% real, yeah, I'm not excited for the day at all, innit? Like, I'm actually kind of annoyed that I have to go.
Who's hungover?
I'm hungover as fuck. I'm trying to do the minimal
You're
amount of work.
You're banned from drinking.
The minimal amount of work possible.
What do you think we'll expect today?
Might be cleaning sheets and beds.
Yeah, but what if there's shit on them?
Good luck to everyone, yeah? Come on, let's go.
Oi, oi. I need more than fucking luck. Morning, everybody.
Morning. Morning.
How are you?
All good, all good.
Did you sleep well?
Yeah, amazing.
No. You don't like your accommodation?
No, it's all right.
I think it's lovely.
Brilliant. So, Lance, what's going on with this lollipop?
Oh, mate.
I didn't really have breakfast, innit?
Okay. You think it's right to have a lollipop and coming to this briefing in the morning? Do you think it's acceptable?
No, not really.
Not really? It looks like you're not taking it seriously. Now, you can have fun, you can party until 4 o'clock in the morning. No problem. But in the morning, when you come in, you've got to be ready for work.
Sorry, Fred.
Good. Now you are all going to help to run this hotel. And today, the staff of the hotel are going to show you the ropes. This is just about to get real. Okay, off you go. Well done.
Thank you.
See you later.
Thank you.
And Levi? No more yawning. I've sent the recruits in various departments of the hotel to do some jobs.
You never opened a bottle of champagne?
I've never opened anything with a cork.
It's to teach them about the basics.
We have the first contact with the guests, so I need to see smiley faces.
Okay. To set the foundation for the way we are going to work.
The recruits are being put through their paces.
Like this? Make it look so easy.
No.
By the heads of department from across the hotel.
Oh, my God!
Before they have to deliver on the hotel's exacting standards by themselves.
OK, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Do you tell us what kind of champagne you have?
Sparkly champagne.
Good champagne.
Oh. Got your yellow-coloured, dark yellow-coloured champagne.
Good champagne. We'll have a bottle of the good champagne.
Oh! Yeah. Nah! Ugh!
Wait. Skip marks!
Ugh! That's not as it works!
Fam, how long do you have to do this?
An hour.
Bonjour, madame. Bonjour, monsieur.
How are you?
I'm doing great today. How are you guys?
Yeah, very good, thank you.
98 quid!
They want two glasses or they want the bottle?
No, they want me your bottle.
Okay.
Yeah. 151 quid.
Oh my
God, the prices here on the menu are shocking. Just go to Asda and get one.
Today, Fred wants to see which recruits pay attention to the smallest details.
Can we maybe get a towel?
Yes, of course.
Thank you.
Two? Brilliant. Thank you.
I don't even clean my own, never mind someone else's shit.
If we just throw everything in the bin, literally everything, even the cups, just throw everything in the bin.
No, we got...
They're not going to notice.
No, I can't.
Champagne, blanc de noir, 2 glasses, the Caesar salad. The recruits are getting on with their job, which is great. These two guests, did you see them?
No.
You didn't see them, you didn't say hello to them. But I've been very disappointed with their job so far. It's about a quest for excellence. And they need to up their game. Be hospitable. This is your pool. This is a 5-star hotel. Come on. This is not Peckham High Street.
After an hour of cleaning, Lance and Dippy are admiring their hard work.
Bonjour.
What are you doing, guys? Why are you sitting on the sofa? Is the room ready? Is it clean?
Yeah.
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 So this is ready for guests now. Obviously, you're sitting on it.
Yeah, sorry about that.
You should be puffing the cushions. Where are the cups for the tea here? The way you made the bed, that is terrible. In a hotel like this, it's wrong. The bed should be completely flat.
I was surprised about his reaction with our bedroom. I thought we'd done a great job. So when he's coming, he's like, pointed out one problem. I'm thinking, cool, the bed, that's it. What else can you say?
Do you think it's clean?
No, I don't think that's
so
clean.
So why is it like that?
I'm not sure.
But why are you smiling? This is not a joke.
Mm-hmm.
It's dirty, you haven't done your job.
Yeah.
And you were sitting there like the king of the castle.
And it's like, something else, something else, something else, something else, something else. I was like, raw, like, I was actually surprised.
How do you have the audacity to wait for me sitting on the sofa there when this is like this?
Brother, if you go to the toilet, you need toilet paper, innit? You know what I'm saying? That's so obvious, bro. But I didn't even notice that, you know what I'm saying? So I'm a bit pissed off about that, innit?
And I come in to check and you said to me, yeah, it's fine, it's perfect.
Honestly, I thought that we'd done a good job at first, but before you pointed out a lot of things.
Right. It's going to be so clean that you can eat on top of the toilets. The toilet's not clean.
Outside, Fred is also expecting perfection from Tom and Levi, who are preparing the pool area for the guests.
Levi, I don't think he has the best work ethic out of the people here. Quite happy to sit in the beach hut and not do a lot and doss about. Even when he did go and put some towels out, I actually had to correct them because they were the wrong way round. How are you finding it in terms of job-wise?
Yeah, it's chilled, isn't it?
You've still got to keep an eye on attention to detail with towels. I wouldn't say it's just a doss job. Keeping on top of it.
Maybe so.
The type of thing that would wind me up is laziness would probably be the main thing. Yeah, you've got to pull your weight, definitely. It's not work particularly, but it's still a job that's got to be done regardless.
So you don't think it's a hard job?
In terms of physical work, no. Quite a simple task to do what we've been asked to do in terms of my normal line of work. What do you do for work?
Social media management.
Social media management, OK. Mm. But you don't actually have a 9-to-5 job as such?
No, I'm lucky I just get to work from a farm.
OK. I see.
Mm.
I'm going to have a look around.
Yeah, you go and I'll wait and see if anyone comes that need towels. And I can't fucking walk in down there.
Fred has promised all 12 recruits the chance to change their lives.
How are you, Lance?
But Lance's attitude is already causing concern.
What's up? You look a bit deflated.
I'm just surprised at your reaction to the room.
Because, why?
Because we actually put a lot of effort into it and you pointed out a lot of stuff that we didn't notice.
So you're disappointed with yourself?
Yeah.
That's good. That's good because it means that you care.
I've never taken anything serious. I'm not used to it, innit? So even this... it's very different for me. I'm still surprised that I'm here.
Why are you surprised?
I never thought I'd ever get an opportunity like this. Like, this is crazy. My life has just completely changed, you know what I'm saying? I've actually got a kid now, and she's 6 months old, so I want to get some skills, just so I know that I'm always going to be able to provide for my family, innit?
You know, the thing with you is that now you've got a child, you've got a responsibility in this job, though. You need to really apply yourself fully. If you don't apply yourself, you're not going to be able to succeed. You need to give it your all. Are you prepared to do that?
Yeah, I am prepared to do that.
You know, there's one opportunity up for grabs here. There's 12 of you. There's going to be one winner. It could be you. Be clever, be smart, Lance. You're not a stupid guy. You have integrity. Use it to your advantage.
Yeah.
You have got an amazing opportunity. Don't blow it.
Fred has provided a staff area for his recruits to unwind between shifts, but differing attitudes to work are creating tension.
What have you been doing?
Housekeeping.
How's that?
We tried our best. We know he's on our hands and knees, so...
I pretty awesome. Enjoyed mine.
What did you have to do?
That's because you didn't do anything.
Tom, when you look this pretty, you should never have to work, babe.
Yes, you should.
I'm sorry, but we're cut from a different class, and it's really something.
Everybody
to...
works.
No, it does my head in. You've probably never even seen anyone from working class. Aim just blabbering on about, oh, well, you've not really done work today. Fucking weird art.
That's so controversial.
It's so controversial. Shut up and take a fucking evening, yeah. I'm like, that's controversial. Fuck off.
Honestly, Tom, do not buy it to that. That's just disgusting behaviour. I am not sticking to
hang
that.
Hang on. He just said you don't know what working class is.
You're right. Who said this? Tell me. Spill.
He's just picked off at me.
I can't stand him. And don't sit there trying to tell me I didn't work because I did.
I saw you didn't really do a lot. I saw you didn't do anything. You just put a few towels out. It wasn't that hard work.
Arrogant little bastard. Great fucking posh. I'll do what I've got to do. I don't need to talk to you.
It's midday at one of the most exclusive hotels in the south of France. And while guests soak up the summer sun...
Bonjour. You're looking good.
Fred Cyriex has called his 12 new recruits to join him at its £10,000 a night villa.
At Les Roches Blanches, the hotel organised special parties in this exclusive villa for their guests. And they expect nothing but the best. This afternoon, there is a 20th birthday party. In France, being 20 is like being 21 in the UK. It's a big deal. This party has been planned long in advance. But there are some things that can only be organized and done on the day. Preparing for the food and the beverage. Where do you think I'm going with this?
The wedding.
Power job.
I think so, you're gonna do the party. Now, before we go any further, who would consider himself or herself a leader? So, four of you put your hand up, but I'm going to give it to Lance. You were quick, you put yourself forward, and you want the responsibility, you can have it.
Cool, thank you.
Okay? What is going to be very important for you, Lance, today is communication.
Okay.
Today is all about teamwork. The party is on from 4 p.m. The clock starts now, and there's only one person in charge, and it's Lance.
Thank you.
Good luck, guys.
Thank you. Thank
and remember, you need to clean that villa before you start, yeah?
Yeah.
Take care.
Thank you.
Since the recruits arrived, I have to say that Lance hasn't been the best. He is messed up. But today, he wants an opportunity. He wants to show what he can do. I'm going to give it to him.
So, team, I'm here. Who's excited?
Yeah! It is a great turnaround from earlier, I'm not going to lie. I'm kind of thrown into the deep end, but I'm ready for it.
The recruits have 4 hours to prepare for the party.
The birthday cake, 4 times sushi platters, and we have to get 200 macarons. I'm not sure what a macaron is.
Is that macaroni? Is that pasta?
That mac and cheese.
So, I've divided the teams into two. So let's get down to the business. Yeah! Right, let's go. Let's do this.
Team leader Lance is heading into town with Pavel and Jackson to find half the party supplies. He's sending Fran, Molly and Sammy to find the rest.
Let's go! Woo!
Lance has put Tom in charge of the other 5 recruits and tasked them with cleaning and decorating the villa.
Levi and Dippy, do you want to get the Hoover back out?
That bit's roped off.
Yeah, but you can still take the Hoover down there and Hoover it, look. It's not roped off anymore.
So why don't you Hoover it while I sweep the stairs? Lovely. Tommy's at it again. We're... Because he's arrogant, no one listens to him.
I'm not saying you haven't done a good job. It's just not up to a 5-star standard. Do you want me to show you?
No.
It's just so frustrating. The whole point of Lance choosing me was that I was gonna be the sub-team leader, and now people aren't listening.
Would you like to show me the dirt, Tom?
More than happy to show you the dirt.
Lovely.
There's a dead ant here.
Would you like to pick that ant up?
There's a stain on the table. There's another bug there. If it's been hoovered, that wouldn't be there.
You've seen me hoover.
I know, I have seen
you
hoover.
You've seen me hoover. Do not. Don't do it. It's rude. Absolutely rude. Tom, shut up.
With just 2 hours before the party starts.
Can we pick up an order?
Yes.
200 macarons.
OK.
The girls are ticking the first items off their shopping list.
Merci. Au revoir. Au revoir. Au revoir. How do you think the boys are doing then?
I hope they're doing shit.
I wouldn't put it past them to be on the beach.
What a strange...
While Lance and the boys...
Rob, where can we get a beer, fam?
...haven't found any of their supplies.
I've got to get these two bottles of creme cassis here, whatever that is. They got the birthday cake, we ain't got to worry about that.
Yep.
Macarons, they got that one as well.
And then we're going to tell them about the sushi.
Thank you for the champagne.
Merci beaucoup.
Despite the time pressure to source everything for the party, Lance is showing little interest in picking up the sushi for the guests.
Je m'appelle,
santé.
Je m'appelle.
I'm so worried that when we pour champagne on it, it's all going to crumble. And then Fred's going to be like, Edda, you are responsible for the champagne tower.
Across town, the villa is far from ready. There's still a champagne tower to construct.
Did you wash these grapes?
No, I didn't wash them. I'll do that now.
And a fruit buffet to finish, plus margaritas to mix.
What have you got to do after this?
We're waiting for them to come back from the shop with one of the drinks, because we need to make cocktails for them.
Do you know how to make a pink margarita?
No, I don't know how to make a pink
margarita. Who's going to be responsible for making the margarita?
I'm not too sure.
Oh, my God.
I know. It looks like a mess.
It doesn't look like a mess. It is a mess, yeah. DP. Where is Lance?
Lawrence has gone into town.
Has he?
Yes.
OK. Six in town and six here?
Yes.
Interesting. OK. Is it what you would have done?
I wouldn't have sent quite so many people into town because still got quite a lot to do left here.
What time is it, Tom?
I don't know what time it is, and I don't have a watch on.
But how can you run an event without having the time?
Yeah, not very well.
There is a clock on the fridge over there. I am seriously embarrassed. I mean, they haven't got a clue. I think the way that Lance has divided the group doesn't work. You should have really two people in town doing the shopping and everybody here working. And there's no leadership here.
In town, team leader Lance has decided to delegate more responsibility to the girls.
Hello? Have you got everything?
No, listen, we've got a bit of a problem because we've been on foot, it's a bit further away than what we thought it is.
Wait, so what do you not want to get?
What's too far?
Now you're messing us about. What's going on?
We need you to get sushi as well.
As well? So you want us to get birthday cake and sushi?
We stopped off at this place now for a drink.
OK.
And a bottle of water.
We don't care for a bottle of water. We wasn't told to get water.
Wait, so you've got nothing?
We're on foot.
OK, Lance, what's going on with your team?
Get them together. You're supposed to be, like, the head of this.
She wants to speak to the manager.
I'd like to make a formal complaint.
You're not pulling your weight, and your weight's rather heavy.
Listen, I'm actually trying my hardest.
We've been walking for ages, yeah?
Yeah, just to let you know, you're slightly knobheads, but, yeah, bye. I'm not usually stressed at all, but right now I am stressed because they've put stress onto me. I had my shit down. We had our shit down. We was ready to go and get our stuff, and then they put onto us the sushi.
Do you know what time it is?
No.
You better find out what time it is. 3:50, you got to be ready. When Lance gets back, he better have a plan, because as far as I can see now, he's just blown it.
We've got 20 minutes, and this thing is a shit show.
Because he needs to get here and sort this out. It's on him.
Only a little bit, though, isn't it?
Yo, we need to... Oh, someone's calling.
What is going on here?
Hello?
Lance?
Hello?
Lance, where are you?
Lance?
I'm in the villa now.
It's a total and utter shambles.
Nothing is ready.
Yeah, we're gonna come back now. We were just struggling finding the margarita. We was literally walking for ages trying to find it.
Well, you better come because...
Nothing is ready here.
Can we get the pickup, please? Because we're on foot.
Lance, I am...
Not Uber.
OK, we're gonna run.
All right. See you then.
Let's peg it, bro.
I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say.
Guys, guest is on their way.
With 15 minutes to go, the recruits are still waiting for the margarita ingredients and the birthday cake. And there's no time for anyone to pick up the sushi.
Where have you been?
Got a bottle, man.
Quick, you need to do the cocktails. We need... How many cocktails is there?
I thought they was going to do a better job than this. It's not finished, you know what I'm saying? It looks like it needs more work.
There's no flowers in the pool, bruv. Where's the flowers?
The winds flew them away.
What? Nah, I'm a manager, innit, so I've got to keep my composure, you get me? I'm going to try to keep it cool, but I'm actually annoyed, innit?
Are you happy with the way it's going?
Nah, I feel like it could go a lot better.
I think you've done very badly so far. You have no time to lose. Lance, you need to wake up.
Oh.
Yeah, Lance was in charge. He wanted to split up. He's fucked himself up. And it's our share.
Is there even one margarita made yet?
Oh, God.
Oh, Lance,
are these going to blow away?
Bro, this is fucking bullshit, bro.
No, 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 calm. It's fine.
A lot of the problem is that people wasn't pulling their weight. If I give them the instructions and they're not listening, what more can I do? Bro, I don't want to do this anymore, man. It's fucking...
What's going on, Lance?
That I just feel like I've been set up to fail, you know what I'm saying?
You are the leader today. You are the manager. You're the one in charge.
Yeah.
You're the one who's made all the decisions. You have two choices now. And you need to make a decision fast because the party is going to start.
Okay.
So you decide to walk or to stay and run the party and be the manager of this event. It's up to you. But if you decide to stay, you've got to put on your smile and you've got to deliver the best hospitality this guy has ever had. If you don't want to do it, you give me your uniform and you go back to England. So I'm going to give you 60 seconds. You decide what you want to do.
Next time...
Do you know what is an oyster? It is sex food.
The recruits get a crash course in the hotel's finest produce.
Oh, don't be doing that!
I'm not tipsy. I'm a wine appreciator.
And must then host an exclusive event to showcase what they've learned.
So what year is that?
1652.
And one of them says au revoir to the competition.
The recruit going home tonight...